Hello, I am glad to have the opportunity to see you again. Since I only have a superficial knowledge of the English language, I need to spend a lot of time in order to at least to some extent clearly pronounce the text accompanying the video in English. To speed up my work and have time to make more videos for you, I am trying to use an artificial speech synthesizer. Please forgive me if anyone doesn't like it. If you think this is really bad, write me in the comments. If many of you are not happy, I will abandon this practice and again read the text for my videos myself.
In the previous video, I measured the V-shaped linear guide of this machine using an autocollimator.
I will call one support side of the linear guide line A, the opposite side line B. Now I will give information about the results of the measurements taken in the previous video. I have already given information about the calculation method. Now I will give a link. I will probably make an additional video about doing the calculations in the future. Data are expressed in arcseconds. The length of the mirror stand is 300 millimeters. The length of the guide is 3 meters. Maximum wear and where it is located. You can check the calculation. It's easy to make a mistake here. But everything seems to be correct.
The task is to repair this guide along with its flat counterpart. Structurally, there are machined straight grooves along this pair of guides, parallel to this pair. Their geometry has not changed during the machine's operation, as they do not interact with any parts. It can be assumed that they were processed with high-quality equipment, and their straightness is higher than that of the worn guides.
I made an animation so you can understand exactly what I mean.
If their straightness is significantly higher than the straightness of the worn linear motion guides, it may be possible to use them to process the worn guides by using a special grinding device, reducing the amount of manual scraping work.
It would be good if the machine manufacturer specifically created such precise surfaces for machine repair. On such a base stand, you need to make two moves.
Therefore, it is necessary to find out how straight they are. The autocollimator is set up.
Thank you, my viewers, for your support. Thank you for your subscription, likes, and financial support through Patreon.
I will prepare the surfaces a bit by removing any patina and blemishes that may have appeared on the surface. I am using a flat surface and sandpaper. If the sandpaper loses some abrasive, it does not pose a threat to the linear motion guide, as cleaning will be done multiple times during the work, and the metal will be removed manually with a scraper, at least at the end of the work. If the measurements show that the deviations from straightness are small, it will be possible to improve the surfaces with sandpaper to enhance their straightness. I'm cleaning the second reference line. Removing dust and abrasive. For this measurement, a stand for the autocollimator mirror has been made with suitable reference points. There are four for the horizontal plane and two for one of the vertical planes. The mirror step movement is 300 millimeters in total. With a total of 10 steps.
Now, we will find out whether these grooves can be used as prямолинейные ones.
Восьмая. Девятая. Десятая.
The first position has the cross in the center. Even in the second position, the mirror shows that these surfaces are very uneven and unsuitable for the intended operation. We observe a deviation from straightness even greater than on lines A and B. That is, on the working surfaces of the guide. Therefore, reducing the amount of manual work in this case won't be possible. To restore the geometry of the guide, it will be necessary to manually scrape off
Well, no problem. In this case, I can make it straight with a scraper.
Now, the next step is to fabricate the required tooling for this repair. Specifically, I need to create a mirror stand with precise prism-shaped support legs. The distance between these legs is 1,000 millimeters. The planes of these support legs must be geometrically accurate.
Each pair of working planes is located strictly in one common plane. This device must be additionally controlled with an accurate bubble level.
Additionally, I'll require a scraper bridge, also 1,000 millimeters long, with an absolutely flat and precise working surface. Plus a sharp scraper and a lot of physical work, that's all.
I have shown through in detail the technology for performing this work. It should be successful. Follow my channel and you will see everything. Thank you for your attention. Goodbye.